Boozy on the track.
And we're back with another video. Now, if this is your first time ever seeing my face, subscribe button down below to join the G gang. If not, then hey, girl, hey, and let's get straight into the video. I don't usually always have my glasses on for videos, especially like my story times, but this time I'm gonna be reading screenshots, so I'm going to be needing them. But before then, I'm gonna take my glasses off because I'm just gonna recap to you what's been going on. You guys know I do story times, and the ones that always the ones that always involve other people, like my ex-best friend wanted to fight me, or my friend stole my man music video, all cards being linked, go check those out. Always the ones with where other people are included that I get backlash on. Now when I say backlash, I mean like y'all love them, you guys love them, but the people that they're about, even though they happened months ago, they're not happy about that. Like the ones where I said I cheated on my boyfriend, I took the backlash on that because that is my truth. I can't take that back. I cheated. I was a cheater. I'm sorry. That was what I did. My dad walked in me in the strip club. That is my truth. But like the other ones where other people are included, I told my truth. Now their truth may be different.
Why you always lying? No, my God. Stop fucking lying.
I've gotten backlash, so I wanted to recap with y'all what it was about. So let's get our glasses on to read these screenshots that we've gotten. So the first one was about the girl from the my ex-best friend wants to fight me. Now again, it's gonna be linked here. Please go watch that video to get the whole gist of why she wants to fight me. And then she, like I said in the beginning of the video, because I was looking for our messages to show you guys what caused the fight, I realized that she blocked me. So I was like, okay, fine, that's great. But then she unblocked me as of recently just to tell me that she's seen my video, y'all. So let's just look at this. She said, bitch, you real life weird as hell. Okay, how the fuck you that beat? I blocked you. You had to go make a whole YouTube video about me. It was a good story time. Why would I not tell it? Like, it's funny. It's like, I thought it was funny, especially because it was a dumbass argument and you wanted to fight me for it. Dick riding at its finest. How about you take my dick out your throat for a minute and tell your subscribers how many niggas you fucking, or how many dicks you could fit in your mouth at once. Worry about your own pussy, sweetheart. Now she said that because I said that when she you gotta watch the music, they gotta watch that video, because I said that she was tricking, and she was at the time, a couple years ago, not when the story time happened, not when it happened, but before, asking me for advice. So she wants to come back and throw it at me. Regardless, if you want to fight or not, I swear to God, when I see you, I'ma spit on your dirty ass. On you, dirty ass bitch. So yeah, I got a lot of hate. Y'all can read that, read the whole thing. Let's see what the other screenshot says. I just respond to her, yeah, go off, sis, because you doing the damn thing, you telling me off. Like, I just did a story time. Like, I didn't even make you look bad. You made yourself look bad because all I did was just read screenshots that you sent me, like, and explained why you sent them to me, but whatever. And then she said, I was going to wait a month and make a video about it. You mad as hell for what? Because I blocked you. I waited a month about it because usually I have a whole bunch of story times that I want to tell, but there's certain things like I want to wait to see if they're gonna pan out in my favor or if the person's gonna apologize. So if I do make a story time on it, I can always come back like in the story time video and say like, oh yeah, so this happened, but this person came back and apologized and we rekindled it, so blah blah blah, we're on good terms now. But I knew this wasn't gonna come back from that, because once you say that you're gonna put your hands on me, that's dead, that's done, that's out the window, we not ever gonna be friends again. I just waited a month to see if anything changed. And I just told story time because I thought it was a good story. But all my other stories happened years apart, just in case, because there's always a situation where it can always change. Then she was like, I was trying to end the conversation. She just kept messaging me. And I was like, she was like, why next time tag her? And I'm like, nah, sis, no clout for you. Like, but yeah, I mean, I don't get a lot of views, but like, even if, like, I'm not gonna tag you in it, the heck I look like Bobo the Fool. Why do they all like to say weird ass bitch? I guess I'm a weird ass bitch. So the next one is about the girl from the freaking My Friend Stole My Man video. Again, link right here, guys. Click it, watch the music video. And we still follow each other. Like, even if I'm mad at somebody, I don't unfollow them. Cause it's like, what's the point? Whatever. I guess I like to lurk low key. Who knows? Block me. I don't give a fuck.
Look on Facebook. Block on WhatsApp. Block on telefoonet. Block on Instagram. Block, 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 block. Afar. Block.
She saw that I promoted my video. Cause I usually promote like my storytime videos on my Instagram. If you guys haven't followed me, follow me there. And then she was like, bruh, you're really the same goofy weird ass bitch. If you're gonna tell a story time, at least tell everything and what the fuck really happened. So when she said that to me, I was like, hold up. Now if you guys listen to that story time again, please go watch it. There is a third girl in that story time that was there for everything, who was caught in the middle between my friendship with the middle girl and her friendship with the middle girl. She was caught in the middle, so she's the middle girl. She watched my story time, and so I called her up and I said, hey girl, did you see any discrepancies between what happened in the story time and what, like, because she's saying boyfriend Steeler is saying that I didn't tell the full story. And she's like, nah girl, like, you told everything. Like, I don't know what the heck she's talking about, because everything you said was what happened, like exactly what happened. I'm like, okay. So I responded, I'm like, oh well, boyfriend Steeler, goodbye. This was 3 years ago, because it was. That is what happened. She said, LOL, exactly. The shit was 3 years ago. Why are you still talking about it then? I just did a story time. It's not like I'm going around telling people like this happened, but it was just a story time. Your name was not involved. Nobody knows who you are. Like, sis, I should be the one mad that this shit happened to me. I told her, I told it because it was a funny story time, and a lot of people that had watched it told me that it was a funny story time, so I put it out. I said, what did I not mention that happened that I did not say? She had nothing to say. She said, you weren't trying to make it a funny story time, so don't even do that. I said what the fuck I said. Stop fucking talking about me. It's weird as fuck. I don't talk about you at all, sis. I don't care about you. Like, so I say my little rant, and like, I don't like when people try to play me, especially in 2020. Like, I get petty. Like, I wasn't petty, but like, I just feel like people feel like they can tell me whatever they want to tell me. And nowadays, like, no, I got thicker skin, sort of. But I'm more petty now, honestly, and I need to change that about me. I need to go back to my old ways. But I feel like with me not getting petty, people will try to walk over me, even though like they feel like there's no consequence for walking over me. And there is, honey, there is. She saw what she said. I said, oh, okay. And I sent her a screenshot, because one of her friends that used to be her friends messaged me and basically has said, oh, how did I know this was boyfriend Steeler's snake ass? And I was like, ooh.
And I, ooh.
So I sent the screenshot with her without showing the girl's name, of course, so that's just confidential. And she was like, I was like, oh well, I have no friends, but some of yours don't like you. I'm done. Bye. Because she told me earlier that I had no friends, and it's true. I only have like two, three friends. So I'm confident that those friends got my back regardless of. But her friends, no, because she'd be doing mad stuff to them. Honestly, it's just like, yeah, I would stop. Blah, 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 blah. I was like, bye. Why are you still in my DMs? And so that was the end of that. She never responded. And actually today I saw her. She looked me straight in my eyes and didn't say not one word to me. So I hate when people be talking a mad mess in the DMs and don't say nothing to you. I wasn't gonna say nothing to her because I didn't come into her DMs talking crazy. Like, I don't know. I don't really have a problem with her. And in the freaking story time, I also did tell her, like, in the story time, again, linked, I definitely did say, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I didn't make her look bad. Like, I just said the story. I mentioned things, like, I didn't make her seem like she was an aggressor or that she was being spiteful. I just said exactly what happened. I didn't really say it in a biased type of way. Yeah, she did F me over, but that's what happened. Like, you're not a bad person. I don't feel like you're a bad person. And I also don't feel like you are, like, you meant to put your hands on me either. That's just what happened, though, because you, I don't know. But I just had to get that off my chest, because I feel like people feel like it's okay when I tell my story times about myself, not including other people. But when somebody knows it's about them and they feel kind of like shameful for it, like they want to come and backlash on me, like, dude, this is exactly what happened. Like, you don't have to come and tell me nothing. Like, your name wasn't involved. Nobody knew it was you unless I confirmed that it was you or say that it was you. And I'm not trying to get sued or sued for defamation, so I'm not gonna say who it was. But this was my little rant, y'all, about my little story time backlash. I'm not gonna stop doing story times. I have a whole bunch of story times that I would tell about some other people, but I'm just waiting for things to pan out with that situation, with other situations and stuff. Like, I'm just waiting, but calm and slow. It is what it is, honey bo. But I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. Like, comment, rate, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.